this video, we are going to see how the record transfer can communicate with the IO device. In the previous video, we have seen how the network can communicate with the RAM and this primary memory. Now we are going to see how it communicates with the IO device. To watch what is the logic behind it. So here, there is 8085, that is the system bus. To which the IO interface is there, to which it communicates the IO devices. Same way it has the interface to which communicates. So, 8085 does not directly communicate through an interface tree, it can communicate. So, how to form the tree? That is what we are doing. The very important steps, these are the basic three important steps in communication. Identify the IO device. There are so many devices connected. From which device the microprocessor? To which are so first identify the IO devices the proper address. Then generate a timing and control signal. Okay, respective signal has to be generated. Then after once the IO device is acquired, then data transfer expects either two IO devices or one IO device. So generate timing and control signals. There are actually basically two concepts called memory mapped IO and peripheral mapped IO. What is peripheral mapped IO? Here directly we give two instructions called in and out. Okay. So in is for reading information to the microprocessor, out means from the microprocessor to the output device. It is a single byte. Sorry, it is a 2-byte instruction. Whereas memory mapped IO, you can use the same STA instructions. STA is stored accumulator, then you will be giving the 16-bit address. So the same thing can be used for connecting, storing the data from the accumulator to the secondary storage, that is IO device output. So if the memory related commands are used for transferring of information to the peripheral IO device, then we call it as memory mapped IO. This will be seen in detail. Okay, now you just know there are two types: memory mapped IO and peripheral mapped IO. So peripheral IO instructions. First, we will see peripheral instruction. There are basically two instructions: in, then 8-bit data. They make it is an address. Then out, then 8-bit address. So when it is when you say 8-bit, that means it is nothing but 2 power 8, that is 256 devices that be connected to the microprocessor. So example in 01 is in port address is 01. The device which is connected to the 01 address, if this statement is executed, it will put data from the input device which is connected to this address into the accumulator. Here out means the contents of the accumulator is sent to this particular device with this address. And this is a 2-byte instruction. Volume and this is a port address. So it is a 2-byte instruction. The time diagram of the out instruction and the first instruction. This monster. This is at this point, at this memory, this out instruction is written. So out 01 is. Since it is a 2-byte, it occupies 2 memory spaces. So 2-0 it is the same. So 0-15, equivalent of 1-3-8-3, and this out address is the next. So how it is, what is the execution time factor? It enters 3 memory cycles. Okay. The first memory cycle is the 4 key states, or the next 2 are 3 instructions. So the first should be the output fetch. Once it is output fetch, then at the 4th cycle T2, the address it has to fetch one of the T2. So it is next memory cycle. Then why it is because out 0 1 2, the value it is only interpreted. It will be understood. And what is the execution part of this? The accumulated value is returned into the respective device. So that is what happening in the third machine cycle. That is why it needs 3 machine cycles and probably 4+3+3, 10 T6. So here the first mission cycle, and the lower order and higher order, the data is based on the first, and then at T3, the respective control signals are set accordingly. Here, ALE goes by negating position address, and after some time it goes to in order to take the data in place. So, I by M bar, it goes to indicating it is a magnetic field. Then, RT bar goes to indicating that it is also magnetic. There is feeling, but it, here it goes combined to further generate and we are not saying magnetic. So, because now the data is present in this instruction is present in the memory address. So, this is also memory, this is also memory. So, here first opcode is fetched, and in the instruction cycle, the data here 2051 is placed. Address and 0 will be data is fetched with space of the data. Then again, this two goes through indicating that this is a magnetic thing. Now, in the third mission cycle, here again it goes by taking the address. So, 01 is placed. See here, here also 01 is placed, here also 0 is indicating both are. Then here also it is same data is present. Okay, then. Here it goes like indicating that now it is doing that IO device, it is not memory. So now it is sending the data to the output device, writing. So what happened? Read goes like. Then this also goes like. So this has no effect on it. But W of signal goes low, indicating that it is writing the memory value to the IO device. And together it generates IO W part. So here I will put it also. Now the accumulated content is placed and at the class T3 cycle the respective data is sent to the IO device. So this is how this is the time diagram of the computer and this is how it goes. Now what are all I have said so given in this. So in M1, opcode fetch, 82 places the higher order memory address, 20 fetch and so on. DH and lower order and AA15 is in the model, indicating that it's a memory related operation. Then it goes to indicating the chemical operation. Then at T2, the microphone sends RT bar control signal, which is combined with IOM bar to generate MEMR. And fetches the instruction code D3. Nothing but this. Using database. On decoding, MP finds out the instructions are proven. So in M2, MP places the reach address 2051H. This one, 2051H. On the address bus, it gets the device address 01H via data bus. In M3, the device address 01H stays on the lower order as well as in the higher order. So it is based on both the higher and lower order. The IO / MPOP goes high, indicating it's an IO operation. It goes indicating it is an IO operation, not memory. So T2, the accumulated contents are placed on the database, followed by control signal that you are on. By adding the IO M bar and the IO operation, IO W bar is generated to enable the output device. The information necessary for the prefix. Okay, now this is the place that we are going to give the information to the IO device. So the data is present at the T2 cycle of this. So this is where we have to catch the data. So our interfacing takes place here only. So far it is memory read only. But here is what the data is sent to the IO device. So here what we have to implement the logic of catching the data. So device selection and data. The objective of interfacing is to get information or input out of the into the process and store it on this table. The out instruction is not the problem. During M3 cycle of the out instruction, the MP places that information on the data. That is how we have placed the data on the data during the M3 cycle. So, if the data bus is connected to the latch, the information can be caught and displayed via LED or printer. The questions are as simple as, when should we enable the latch to catch the information? What should be the address of the class? So, what are the questions? The answer is that in M3 cycle, the lab should be enabled when IO / MR is high and WR is active mode. So, at that point, we have to catch them. So, the address on output port is also on on the address. So that is also output port address is also present here. Okay. It is also present here. So the address of output is also at that very MQ0. The steps to be done for device selection and data analysis. Decode the address bus to generate a unique pulse corresponding to the device address. We have to decode a special unique pulse combining the device address. This is called device address pulse or IO address. Combine this device address pulse with the control signal so that then only we will know whether it is a unique or not. To generate a device select pulse that is generated only when both signals are accepted. Use IO select pulse to activate the interfacing device. Now we will see end instruction timing also. We have seen previously out instruction. We will see this also before moving to the next one. So let us consider this same instruction in AD4. This is the port address. Okay, device address. Now the equivalent mnemonics is exported PP and AD4. It is stored at 65 and 66. And the rest of the timing diagram is here. So 20-65, then we will have one. Output is fetched. So then it finds the 2 byte. So the next cycle, AD4 is fetched. So the respective signals are activated. So this is a memory rate memory. So the RT bar goes low, the respective reading. And the IO selection bar goes low, getting it is a memory. Mainly, IPR, when the address is placed, goes high. And then the data is placed, goes low. Then, here at memory M3 cycle, this needs 2 bytes, but it needs one more memory cycle because in AD4 we create the data from the memory address, this port address 84, in the data in the accumulator. So, what happens? This is what connector at this point, the particular port address is connected, so the port address is here. So, that address is sent to the address lines and data. Now it is connected and data from that port will be read and placed on the data bus. So this is the place where we have to go over interfacing. Okay, here how it is read by taking the read signal, again it goes low and here IO or bar, because this is not memory read, this is from the IO read. So it goes low, negating that it is an IO read. Now, how will you move interfacing? We know where we have to find the data. At M3 cycle, we have the port address as well as the data. So we have to catch these two things and interface accordingly. So decoding logic for that, let us consider this is a this gives a block diagram of the interfacing. So here the address lines are there. This will be decoded and this generate a device pulse. Device are IO address pulse. Then this control signal, whether it is read or write, that will be combined and added, and it will select the IO. It will generate a device select pulse, which in turn will be able to help us to latch to a keyboard, an input device, or to an output device. This is a general block diagram. Now, we'll see here. This is an example. A0 to A7, because of the data bus, this data is present. And this is what we have seen in the timing data. Data bus, there is the port address. So that is what we are going to catch. So from that, the data will be taken. And it is given to our NAND. Okay. So here it is 1, and all are 0. So 0, 1 will be the device address. So this will generate a device address, and whether here what we are doing is LED. We are sending the signal to an LED. So which means output port. Now it is an output port. This is what we have seen here. Think how 0 address. So for this only we have seen as so 1 all 0. So 0 0 0 0 1. So this will generate an IO address, which is combined with the control signal. So this generate IOW bar. This is what you'll be able to know that data. So which signal? that also we can catch it here. So this control signal, it is with another gate. We call it as a gate 1 and gate 2 for our easy understanding. So to this gate 2, use two data is sent. And then this will uniquely select a particular, it will be given, this IOSEL will be given to a latch where this data will be eligible. Because it is out, okay, out 01H. This LED will be the our output port. So the data is placed on the accumulator. The accumulator data is placed on the data bus. Okay, so in the address bus, we have the address of the port. And the data bus we place the accumulator. So this is what is sent to the LED lights. So these are all the LED lights selected. So T0 to 0. So whatever is placed on that, the data will be sent. If it is 0, it will not glow. If it is 1, it will glow and show us the off. Now, we'll see what is absolute versus partial decoding. When all 8 address lines are decoded with relative unique outputs, we call it as absolute decoding. So, for example, here, partial decoding, when only few address lines are used for relative unique output, we say it as a partial decoding. Because of this, a device can have multiple addresses. In this figure, the address line A1 and A0 are not connected. You see that A0, A1 is not connected. Whereas A2, all these are connected. To this NAND gate, we have IO/MBAR and IO or not. So this must be one that is IO, right? Definitely IO will be I1 and this will be 0. So what happens? NAND gate will be selected and device selectors will be selected. This in turn will take data from the data bus and send to the LED line. So here A1 and A0 are not connected. This is called partial decoding. If A0, A1 is also given, that is full address line, or A0 to A7 is used, then we call it a absolute. Whereas here it is partial decoding. Those two address lines can be used for something else. So this is a very partial decoding. Now we'll see one example for interfacing with the input device and another example for that with the output device. So decoding logic for a tip switch. So let us consider this as a keyboard. Tip switch is when you press the key. Okay, so let us consider this as a tip switch. So 8-8 data, if you press one switch itself, it will decode the combinations and it will say what data is pressed, whether I am pressing A or whether I am pressing B like that. Okay, so it will be connected to the systematic that fixed it. So here A0 to A7 is all are given 1. See here it will directly put it into inverter. Then T1, here output will be 0. And it is combined with this IO-ARPA. This device calls. This control signals. This device calls is combined with the control signals, which is given to G2. And this uniquely selected IO, the device selector, which in turn selects this tray state buffer. So, whatever the data is pressed by the user, that will be taken and placed on the data bus. So, this is an input device. So whatever is selected, this particular, if it is connected from this this input device, the data will be sent to the data bus, which will be read by the next one. Now, interfacing IO using decoders. Let us consider a decoder, 3-2-8 decoder, and this is one latch, and this is another latch. This is an output port, and this is an input port. Now here, A0 to A1, A2, these are all placed on the port address, as port address. So 0-0, here we can give, if it is selected, then 0-0-0 should be done in order to select this output. Now, this is an input, that is, the data given here is sent to the input, then the input to the microprocessor. Here from the data bus, it is sent to the LED bus. This is one output port, this is one input. This is an output, connected to an output device, and this is connected to the input device. Now here A0 to A2. So when I give all zeros, this will be selected. Okay? When I give O2, see here O2. So this has to be selected with 0, 1, 0 must be given here in order for this to select. Then all this must be 1. Then only this will be selected. So if you see the combinations A0, A1, A2, I say zero and all zeros for this all or one. So if I have selected as one and this one, that is F, and this is A. F8 will be the port address of this. So that will be generated, will be here. So this is what F8, which in turn combined in the gate 2, and then this selected me IO set pulse, which in turn select this port. And so whatever data is present in the data bus will be placed on the LED with respect to light blue. Here, input port, FA. Okay, so FA means here it should be 0, 1, 0. So 1, 0, 1, 0 means A. But this is itself. So FA has, this will be generating FA input pulse. So in turn, combined to select an IO is here, where selected tri state buffer, where the input is selected based on the bit switch, whatever the data pressed by the user, that will be sent to the data bus, which in turn will be